Welcome back. Today we took out a beautiful Boston Whaler 160 Supersport. A great model, which to be honest is one of my personal favorites because it reminds me of a Boston Whaler 130 Supersport that I used to own a couple of years ago, of which I have really good memories with my family. And this is a brand new boat, a 160 Supersport, and I especially like the styling. And there are some really nice features and options now for 2021. This is a brand new boat. There were actually 0 hours on the engine when we put it in the water this morning. It's a beautiful day in May. So let's start as usual, beginning at the bow. There are quite a few options on this boat, but of course, like we're used to with Boston Whaler, we always have nice stainless steel cleats made out of 316 quality, and I especially like the detailing such as this navigation light with this small edge here so that you cannot chafe the line like it is used here at this moment. This bow rail, of course, also in stainless steel, is an option, and the same is with the rub rail, which optionally is made out of white with a stainless steel insert. I think it's a beautiful detail which matches the whole boat. And you may have noticed that the boat has the optional light gray hull on the sides, and also there's a stainless steel bow eye below there. A really nice detail, a really sturdy look, and of course there's a practical use to that also if you do a lot of trailering or use it for towing behind a big mothership or something like that. I really think it matches the quality and the styling of any Boston Whaler, but especially on this 160 Supersport. A huge bow area here with an optional bow cushion, which I think everybody will be ordering, with of course below the anchor locker, which is really big. As you may notice, we didn't bring an anchor this time. And this can also be used as some sort of a live well, because of course you can put the drain plug in there and fill it with water, or maybe use it as some sort of cooler to keep your drinks cold during a beautiful sunny summer day. And I again like the details like we're used to in the meantime, but it isn't very common in other boats, but just small nice details such as this possibility to grab this lid, and also these hinges which are made flush in the deck, non-skid everywhere on places where you need it. So really nice detailing. Also a small detail such as this. Everybody who's used to boating knows that this can be quite a challenge, fixing these, not on a Boston Whaler like this. They just found a practical solution. And not only that, these are also made that they more or less ventilate so that they are kept in a good condition if the boat is 10, maybe even 20 years old. We find Boston Whalers to still have really good cushions because they are made out of a really good quality material, but also in a way that they can ventilate. Having the possibility to fold this, of course, is a nice practical detail also. So again, a lot of thinking has been done by the design team of Boston Whaler, so a huge compliment for that. Really nice detailing. We are always surprised, to be honest, because we're working with Boston Whaler for many years, and we sometimes think a new model, why? The current model is already really good. But then when a new model comes out, such as this 160 Supersport, there's even more nice and new features, nice practical details. So well done, Boston Whaler. As mentioned, this is an option. This, by heart, I think is a standard, like here on this side. Very practical. If you're sitting here, we tend to use this, but it's also practical to use this one on the lower end here and to attach fenders like we did here just now. So again, non-skid on many places. The optional cooler here, really huge, with a nice optional cushion on the top. We put our stuff in now, so we're using it for storage. There's cup holders, 1, 2, 3, 4. Of course, made of stainless steel with drainage, like we're used to with Boston Whaler. This is the place where you attach the top light, which is stored there with the dedicated storage. And what I like, what I think Boston Whaler has done in a really good way, is having this storage, a locker, a lockable storage, I should say, a really nice hinge, maybe even overdone, but that says something about how a Boston Whaler is made. So it's nice detailing everywhere, small things like this. This here, so that the water doesn't come in, but still a small drainage hole here. And like I mentioned, it is lockable. So I put my phone there now, but if you put your phone, wallet or whatever there, you can lock this area. Steering position, of course, steering wheel with the nice Boston Whaler logo. Switch for the navigation and the anchor light. A 12 volt connection here. A rev counter. CE plate for Europe. This may be the moment that I need to mention that this boat is fitted with a 100 horsepower Mercury 4-stroke engine. But in the US, it is sold with, I think as a standard, with a 75 horsepower and optionally with a 90 horsepower. But here, we're in Holland, we're the dealer for Holland and Belgium. But here, optionally, it is not a 90, but a 100 horsepower. And also, the CE, the European approval, I should say, has a mark here, which says that it is approved for 6 people. Which I think for a 16 footer is great, but still my gut feeling says that it can carry even more people, because you, of course, you can have 2 people here, 1, maybe even 2 kids here, and at least 3 people there in the area, not to mention this huge space in the back here. Again, this reminds me of my 130 Supersport, and I remember that I used to bring a huge Fat Boy, which I put in here, which is very practical for lounging. If you're on an island like we're today, you put the Fat Boy on the island and you have a nice place to sit on. But there's plenty of space in this boat. The fuel tank is below here. Now, this is fitted with the optional, I think it's around 70 liters fuel tank, which I think is a great place because it's out of the way. They're usually not really good looking. Of course, it's bright red, which adds to the safety. But what I like also is that there's a filler here, just a small detail, but we all know that boats like these, my 130 Supersport, I think I had 2 tanks below here, I'm not sure, but you always needed to take them out to be able to fill them, not on this 160 Supersport, because they made this filler right here, which is just very practical. I really love these bucket seats also, by the way, and they look good, they're practical, they're high quality, nice stitching made by Boston Whaler. But what I like, and what many people tend to forget, is that they have a really good ergonomic shape. It just makes you feel safe, but also very comfortable. You can sit and relax like this. But what I like, especially with these bucket seats, is that they have quite high backrests. I see a lot of boats in Holland, we have lots of sloops, between 5 and maybe 8-9 meters, even bigger. And they sometimes have backrests which are only this high. And when you see a boat for the first time and when it's new, they look fantastic. But if you really get to use it and take a boat out for a day, for a trip to Amsterdam here in the Netherlands or some other area, and you sit on a boat for 3-4 plus hours, this is what you appreciate, really high backrests. So this is where this boat, I personally think, truly excels. It's really practical. There's a lot of attention to detail, there's lots of space, and everything is just like the way it should be. I'm really excited about this 160 Supersport. going back, of course, there's throttles here, but the throttle, but we'll take it out for a spin later. There's some more nice detailing, a small storage area in one way here, so where you can store things, but it also takes cabling, etc., out of sight. So it looks clean, very tidy, and I really like that. Also here, a cleat which is made in a way that it's designed to be out of the way, more or less. Stainless steel again, and the white rub rail carries all the way through around the complete hull. And what I also like is these dual swim platforms. Of course, there's a swimming ladder on one end, which is here. But what I like also is that they're angled a bit, so that the bathing ladder is installed in a way that is angled away from the engine with a potentially sharp propeller. So this adds to the safety. Safe, practical, really well done. And of course, like we're used to, this is also something that I like to point out. This is a really good long bathing ladder. It seems very obvious, but trust me, a lot of boat builders would fit on a boat like this, only a ladder with three steps, maybe even two, making it difficult to get out of the water, not on a Boston Whaler. Of course, also nice stainless steel quality, 316, so done in a really nice way. Let me do this properly. The boat is not self-baling. It's just too small to be self-baling, but still, if water would come in, there's a drainage here. So if you speed up the boat slightly, take out the drain plug here, then it would drain the water out. Of course, there's an optional ski pylon also on the boat. This customer didn't choose to have one because we have bridges, and I think it's being used at the Vecht, which is a beautiful area, but with lots of low bridges, so it would be too high, I think. And also another detail, it may be difficult to show, but I really love, let me just do like this, I really love these chrome Boston Whaler badges. Really, really good, really nice looking. Let me think if there's anything else I forgot. I don't really think so, let's take her out for a spin. Off we go. I am still, even though I'm used to many outboards, of course, but with these new four-stroke outboards, I'm still surprised because the engine is running, but you hardly hear it running. Of course, we're sheltered now, zero wind here in between the islands, but still you hardly hear the outboard. I'm sure that if you have a Force 2 or 3, you really need to listen when it's running at idle, if it actually is running. Really nice. And what I've noticed also, by the way, before we take her out on the water for some speeding, what I like with many boats is when I am taking a boat in and out of the mooring, I like to be able to do this while using the throttle and control engine controls with the other end. And as you may see, this is really easy to do on this boat, even though it doesn't have hydraulic steering. It's just plain cable steering, but it still works well. So let me take her out. Let me put the man overboard cord around my leg. We're doing slightly over 1000 RPM at the moment. I can't see the speed, maybe. Let me take my app out to actually see the speed in kilometers. Where is it? Here it is. Going out on the Westeinder Lake. Current speed. It is in knots, actually. Let me try getting it 2 kilometers an hour while we're taking her out on the water. I'll leave it on knots for this time. doing 5 knots, which is slow driving in between the islands. Still really smooth and quiet. There's quite a wind, so we're staying sheltered here. Let me pick up some speed. 1500 RPM, doing 6 knots. The engine is tilted down, of course. 2000, slightly over 2000, doing 7 knots. And let me take her up to plane, gently. Still brand new, so we have to be slightly careful with the engine. 40 knots, and we're planing. Boat to have the wind in our backs because of the audio. Doing 17 knots at the moment, slightly over 3000 RPM, and this is a really nice and comfortable speed. Just feels very stable, very safe, very comfortable, easy turning. Again, with just one hand, the other way. I need to. Tilting up the engine a bit. 20 knots. Beautiful day out on the lake here in Aalsmeer. Let me pick up some speed. 21, 22, 23, 24. Really fast. 30. Imagine owning a boat such as this, being only 16 foot, which is very practical. It's small, but carrying it on a trailer behind your car and going to the Mediterranean or some nice European lake, it's easy to take with you, but still, there's plenty of space to carry 6 people or maybe even more in some special cases. So a really practical and nice boat. And with that, I'd like to round up this review. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments section. This boat will be going to the owner soon, but that is actually close to us. So if you have a special interest, please let us know. So we can, if you're from Holland or Belgium, of course, we can show you this beautiful Boston Whaler 160 Supersport. Again, thank you for watching. Hope to see you next time.